Hi, I'm Ms. Hearn. Let's get started. In this video, we're going to talk about normal distributions and the empirical rule. Normal distributions of random variables occur in nature, and graphs of their relative frequencies can be very powerful analytical tools. A normal curve is basically a symmetric bell-shaped curve. Any random variable whose graph has this characteristic shape is said to have a normal distribution. It's called normal because it occurs in nature very frequently. One example of where we see a normal distribution is in IQ scores. In this graph, we can see that the mean IQ score is 100, and that's the score that occurs the most in the distribution. So it's also the mode. Since it's in the middle of the distribution, it's also the median value of the distribution. Notice that IQ scores very high above 100, like 160, occur very rarely, as do very low IQ scores like 40. On a normal curve, if the quantity shown on the horizontal axis is the number of standard deviations from the mean rather than the values of the random variable itself, we call the curve a standard normal curve. Here's the IQ normal curve, but we've replaced the data values of 100, 115, 130, with the number of standard deviations away from the mean, or the z-scores of those data values. This curve has been standardized, meaning that the data has been converted to z-scores for analysis. This is important because our reference materials for normal curves will refer to the z-scores, not IQ scores or other values that we might be trying to analyze. In every normal distribution, the mean is equal to the median, which is equal to the mode. So the graph of a normal curve is bell-shaped and symmetric about a vertical line through its center. It's also true that 68% of all the data will lie within one standard deviation of the mean, 95% of the data will lie within two standard deviations of the mean, and 99.7% of the data will lie within three standard deviations of the mean. We will refer to these three values as the empirical rule. Let's apply the empirical rule and determine what percent of the data in a normal distribution is more than three standard deviations away from the mean. Here I've labeled the number line underneath the normal distribution with the z-scores, or the number of standard deviations the data values lie away from the mean. Between the z-score of -3 and 3, all the data is within three standard deviations of the mean, which lies at a z-score of 0. According to the empirical rule, 99.7% of the data lies within that interval. We're being asked how much of the data is outside of that interval. Well, 100% of the data is underneath the curve. We're going to take away the data that's between -3 and 3, which is 99.7% of the data. So 100 minus 99.7 is 0.3%. How much of this data, the 0.3%, is above the mean? Well, half of that 0.3% is below the mean, and half of that 0.3% is above the mean. So 0.3% divided by 2, or 0.15% of the data, is above the mean. Now let's apply the empirical rule to a word problem. Suppose that 280 sociology students take an exam and that the distribution of their scores can be treated as normal. Find the number of scores falling within two standard deviations of the mean using the empirical rule. It's important to note that we can only use the empirical rule because we're told that the distribution is normal. Since we're talking about scores falling within two standard deviations of the mean, we are referring to data values that have z-scores between -2 and 2. And according to the empirical rule, 95% of the data values in a normal distribution lie in that interval. Well, if 95% of the data is going to be within two standard deviations of the mean, then 95% of those 280 sociology students are going to have exam scores in that range. To find 95% of 280, we're going to multiply 0.95 times 280, which is 266 scores. The area under the normal curve can be interpreted in different ways. I've been referring to it in terms of a percent, but it can also be thought of as a probability or as an area. This is important because you're going to be asked questions, in some cases referring to the area under the curve, in other cases referring to the percentage of data values, and in other cases referring to the probability, and it's all going to be answered in the same way. 100% of the data in any normal distribution lies somewhere under the standard normal curve. The decimal form of 100% is 1.00, or just 1. So we can think of the total area under this curve as being 1. Because of the symmetry of the curve, 50% of the data lies to the right of the mean, or in other words, 50% of the data is above a z-score of 0. This means that the area to the right of the mean is the decimal form of 50%, which is 0.50, or 1/2. Similarly, the area to the left of the mean is also 1/2. Now, we could have changed the question that we asked earlier to refer to area instead of percentage. So how much of the area under the standard normal curve is more than 3 standard deviations away from the mean in a normal distribution? Before, we were dealing with percents, so we said 100% minus the 99.7% that's within 3 standard deviations of the mean would be 0.3%. But since we're thinking of this in terms of area, we would say the 1 whole area minus the 0.997, the decimal form of 99.7%, is going to leave an area of 0.003, the decimal form of 0.3%. This also means that the probability of a randomly selected data item falling more than 3 standard deviations away from the mean is only 0.003. Because when it comes to normal curves, area, percent, and probability are all the same. I hope you found this video helpful. If you did, please remember to give it a thumbs up. That helps other students to find the video.